We now join the first quarter in progress. This is the 1972 Grey Cup Classic matchup from Iverwind Stadium between the Saskatchewan Roughriders and the Hamilton Tiger Cats. The game is currently scoreless.
Cossack up to the 19-yard line. A 4-yard return met by Gord Christian, 72, and Tony Gabriel, number 77. The kick traveled 42 yards, so both the punters today exceeding their seasonal averages early in this game. Seven minutes and 10 seconds to play in the opening quarter. And Abinchan is back in for Saskatchewan. That's good news for the Western champion. Two fakes. Lancaster is a marker. Is strong. Deep for Campano. It's picked off by Al Brenner. Brenner at the 53-yard line. He picked off 15 to set an all-league record in the regular season, but we have a marker down.
Lancaster faking to the back now and trying to run Campana down the seam with the Tiger Cats in his own defense, but Al Brenner, number 25, who's been doing it all year, moved in front of Campana, and Lancaster actually didn't throw that ball far enough, and Campana made the tackle. Penalty against Saskatchewan for holding, and it is turned down naturally by the Tiger Cats, and they have a first down now on the Saskatchewan 52-yard line.
Richardson on the right side with Coffey. Darnie Henley, the flanker, is loose on the left. Fleming and Buchanan are set back. Dave Fleming finding his way down to the 49. The gain is going to be 3. He was stopped by Ted Duschinski, number 27. So the first real turnover goes to Alan Brenner, the guy who did it so often all season for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. He picked off 4-1 game, the last league game against the Toronto Argonauts. Canada's outstanding player, Garney Henley, makes the catch at the 33-yard line. The gain is 16. Robinson brought him down.
Well, Garney Henley just lining up outside Duschinski, and he faked a little to the outside, came into the middle on a bend-in pattern, and found the slot between that outside halfback and the deep safety. But we didn't see in that isolation Dave Buchanan, who lined up in the backfield, came out into the flat, and he ran across Duschinski's nose, and he forced him to stay to the outside.
Tommy Joe Coffey, and stepping out at the Saskatchewan 12-yard line. What happened there, Russ? Coffey got away from that Saskatchewan coverage.
Well, the big situation there was Chuck Ealy dropped straight back, and as the rush came on, they turned Bill Baker to the inside, the left defensive end, and Chuck Ealy then rolled around him. It's what you call a drag pass in some terminology, where the quarterback goes straight back, lets the rush come to the pocket, and then they try and turn that defensive end to the inside. And they did that to Bill Baker that time, let Ealy to the outside. The corner must come up for Ealy, and Tommy Joe just drops in behind him.
Moved the ball some 37 yards in two plays. That was a gain of 21. Buchanan. He cannot get away from Tim Roth, number 66. A loss back to the 16-yard line. Loss of 4 on the play. This is Hamilton's deepest penetration of the game. Their best scoring chance right here. Second and 14 coming up.
Good play by Tim Roth there as John Holman pulled on him, and Dave Fleming was leading the play, and he split the middle of those two offensive players, came in and made the tackle and threw Buchanan for that 4-yard loss.
Five receivers downfield. That is a touchdown for Dave Fleming, number 21, as the Saskatchewan Roughriders protested. But the official right there said he was inbounds, but he made the catch, and that's what counts.
Just a great catch by Dave Fleming here, who went down with Roy Robinson, number 14, covering him man on man. And he turned to the outside and had Robinson turned a little to the inside. He had Robinson turned in, and it was questionable whether he caught the ball inbounds or out of bounds. And the official right down the line called him inbounds for the first scoring points of the game.
Ian Sutter will attempt the point after for the Tiger Cats. It is good. So Hamilton off to a converted touchdown lead, 7-0. 4 minutes and 16 seconds left in the opening quarter. And on the scoring drive, they march 52 yards. Three passes, two rushes, getting three first downs along the way, capped by that 16-yard tip from Ely to Dave Fleming. Seven nothing Hamilton. And congratulations all around to that Ticat bench for number 21. Ian Sutter getting squared away for the Hamilton kickoff. Tom Campana, 17. Bobby Thompson, number 26. Into the short zone near the 20-yard line. Steve Molnar. Molnar is taken down across the 30-yard line. Bob Krause, number 14, made contact, and he was grounded just outside the 30. We'll make it the 31. Return was 11 yards.
Don Krause is a little shook up out there. He made sort of a head-on tackle on Molnar, and he's not that small, Molnar. He ran right over him, and Krause was a little slow getting up, but he's staying on there.
Saskatchewan still in search of their first down of the game. George Reed near the 33-yard line collects about 2.5 before Inskeep 65 and Bloom 70 met him. That is the first carry for Reed in the game. Although you can look to see George carrying the ball as this afternoon goes along.
Well, Ron Lancaster told me yesterday at their final practice, Don, that they were going to try and feel out the Tiger Cats and see what type of defense they were going to use. They expected two or three things from them, and he said, we have to find out what their pattern is going to be, then we'll try and work at whatever they give us.
Second and eight. Open is Barwell, and he steps out ahead of the first down marker. This will be Saskatchewan's first down of the game. 9 yards was the gain. This is what we felt the Saskatchewan Rough Riders might be doing today, Russ, and that's working those very short sideline out patterns. And so far, that's been their biggest play.
Well, this is what the Ottawa Rough Riders did in that first game of the two-game total point, with Lewis Porter and John Williams playing up so tight and basically in a zone defense. They must retreat very quickly to get deep in that zone. And therefore, an outside receiver who goes down about 7 yards and breaks to the outside does have an advantage on them.
Campana's slipping, getting just back to the line of scrimmage. Mike Bloom and Bruce Smith pinning him down for the Tiger Cats. The score is Hamilton 7 and Saskatchewan nothing. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. Ron Lancaster, 2nd and 10, 42-yard line at Saskatchewan. Marker has been thrown. This is George Reed. He did not have the first down. He was tackled at the 48-yard line by Lewis Porter. The Riders' third down was still four to go from their own 48-yard line. The first time they had the penalty, Alan Brenner made the interception, and of course it stood. The Tiger Cats sending back Sternberg with Clark inside their own 15-yard line. That's Clark on the left. Bob Pierce is the Saskatchewan punter. Low snap. He has it blocked on him. And Hamilton is inside the 15-yard line as Bobby Krause recovered the block kick, or made the block kick. And it was Williams, John Williams, number 23, getting in there.
Here we see this block punter. We don't see the low snap that Bob Pierce isn't getting. The ball bounced to him. He fielded it. And then it was blocked now by Krause, number 14. And John Williams, who was coming in from the left side, picked it up. And Pierce made the tackle. And he was complaining that he took the ball away from Williams. But here we have the second big break for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. First and 10 on the Saskatchewan 15.
Broad of Buchanan, and the Rough Riders read it perfectly. Charlie Collins, number 31, getting to him. The loss is going to be 3 yards, back near the 19. It will be second and 13 now. Baker, Banuk, Perdoni, and Roth all dig in. Ely, a good block for him. No one there in that corner. The closest man to it was Ted Duschinski of the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Dave Fleming had been the intended pass receiver, but he didn't reach the area of the ball.
Well, both Fleming and Garney Henley, who had gone out to that side, looked at each other after the ball was thrown, and I'm sure each of them thought the other one was going to the corner, and as Chuck Ely put it out there, there was just no one there. Saskatchewan Rough Riders, who don't blitz too often, came on with Roy Robinson that time up the middle, but he was picked up by number 20, Dave Buchanan.
Ian Sutter's field goal attempt will come from the 27-yard line, just about straight away. And the young man who booted five last week has his first of the day. And it gives the Tiger Cats a lead of 10-0. We have a minute and 2 seconds to play in this opening quarter at Arthur Wynn Stadium. 27-yard field goal by Sutter. The converted touchdown scored by Dave Fleming. And it's been all tie caps in the opening quarter. The Riders at first down from their own 35-yard line. Barwell is set wide on the right side. Campana is on left. Thompson now in motion left. Number 26, George Reed has the ball with a 5-yard gain of the 40. Met by Mike Bloom, number 70. Reed's second carry of the game. Here's John Wells again.
Thanks, Don. Jim Walter was injured for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders early in this game. He's now gone to the dressing room. Apparently, he's got some bruised ribs, but the doctors aren't taking any chances, so they're going to go in and take a closer look in the dressing room. It'll mean Costa will be running back punts for the Rough Riders.
All right, John, this is second down from the 40-yard line, and 5 to go for the Rough Riders. Reed again, and he comes up with the first down, I believe, at the 45-yard line. As the Riders start to go, their dependable number 34 more frequently. Angelo Mosca, 68, and Bruce Smith, 61. The two defensive tackles were there to make the stop, and now they confirm it is a first down for Reed and the Rough Riders. Two straight carries, 5 yards apiece. Clyde Brock working on the right side against Inskeep and Angelo Mosca, and Ralph Galloway, the other offensive tackle, trying to clear things on the left side against George Wells and Bruce Smith.
Number 42, Larry Bird was shaken up on that play, Don, and John Reed, number 44, has come in to replace him at offensive center.
That was Saskatchewan's second first down of the game. But it's completed to Alan Ford across the 55-yard line for the third Saskatchewan first down of the day. The game was 11. Rick Shaw, number 17, a big 6'4 defensive back, made the Hamilton tackle. And that was the final play of the opening quarter. The score is Hamilton 10 and Saskatchewan nothing. The 1972 breakup game continues in just a moment. These are the lovely young ladies from across Canada, the 9 Miss Grey Cup contestants, enjoying this Grey Cup game, as I'm sure fans are all across the country. You know, Russ, Bob Layton, our statistician, points out that in terms of possession in the first quarter, Hamilton had the ball for 10 minutes of the 15. And there you see the stats as they compare the two teams in the opening 15 minutes of play. Mostly Hamilton. All points Hamilton scored against the wind. Lancaster to begin the second quarter with a handoff to George Reed. Good opening as the big fullback gets inside the 45-yard line. The gain is going to be 9 yards. He was stopped by Alan Brenner, number 25, for Hamilton.
Now, the first two or three times that Reed carried the ball off tackle, he went to the inside and didn't get too many yards. And on that particular play, he started to the inside, broke around the outside, and made about 9 yards. With 1 yard to go, Don, the Saskatchewan team now going to their short yardage offense. They bring in those big backs, and you don't know which way Reed's going to go, but 90% of the time, he's going to get the ball.
This time it is Steve Molnar at the 40-yard line. Molnar with a gain of 4 has more than enough for the first down. Mark Cosmos, the middle linebacker, number 45, met him. You know, Cosmos was saying before the game it was a real challenge to him to be confronting George Reed, as Wayne Harris has done over the years in the West. It's Ted Dushinsky there at the Saskatchewan bench putting that hand in ice. Pitch out to George Reed again. The big guy strikes the gun. Brenner finally has him at the 20-yard line. Saskatchewan's longest gain of the day. 21 yards for number 34.
Well, a good call by Ron Lancaster that time, because the Hamilton defense was in more or less a split six defense. They've got two linebackers, both Bloom and Cosmos, on the inside. And once they got Reed outside, they had a lot of running room, because John Williams didn't have Mike Bloom out there on the corner. He came up to turn it up, and Al Brenner was well downfield and didn't come up fast enough.
From the 19 of Hamilton, Saskatchewan's best scoring chance of the day, right here. This is Gordon Barwell. He has the first down near the 8-yard line. Lewis Porter, 24, and Al Brenner, 25, combined to bring him down as the Rough Riders get their offense moving.
Well, the Hamilton defensive backs have been playing off about 12 yards on the Saskatchewan receivers, and the short pass plays are going to be successful for Saskatchewan as long as they continue to play off. That time, Ronnie Lancaster almost overthrew Barwell, but he made a good catch and got the first down.
Ford and Barwell are wide right, Campana on the left side. First and touchdown to go. There's the first Saskatchewan score of the Grey Cup game, Tom Campana, the West top rookie of 1972. Is he happy? As are Saskatchewan fans right across the country.
Don, Lewis Porter is a little upset, because in that particular play, Bob Pierce ran to the inside, and he is complaining that he was screened off. We'll see Bob Pierce here now. He starts to the inside, and you can see that number 33, Sternberg, gets blocked out of there by Pierce. And Lewis Porter, they were playing man-on-man, who was coming across, saw this, and he complained to the official, but the touchdown's going to stand, and we now have the score 10-6 with the convert to come.
By Jack Abenchang, and there it is, a 10-7 Grey Cup game. You begin to wonder what the advantage of wind is all about, because all the points have gone against it. The score is Hamilton 10 and Saskatchewan 7, and the 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. That last completion was the longest of the day for Ron Lancaster, a 20-yarder, Russ.
Well, Alan Ford, again, working on Rick Shaw. We see him coming up, number 17, and the key is he's coming up to make that tackle. They've got Rick Shaw off the line about 12 yards, and they're just working on that area now, trying to complete those passes for the first downs. But when Shaw missed the tackle, it gave Alan Ford plenty of running room.
Dave Scrine has seen Lancaster hit on 9 of 12 for 88 yards and one touchdown. He's having a fine day. This is George Reed, number 34, room outside, and he uses it down to the 34-yard line. He was clotheslined finally by Mark Cosmos, number 45. One of the few head-on confrontations between the battle lines we thought might be drawn, and Cosmos, the linebacker, against Reed, the running back.
George Reed going outside now, and Mike Bloom being fought off by the offensive block. And as George Reed comes in the middle, we'll watch Cosmos come across, and he clotheslined George Reed and took him right off his feet.
Saskatchewan on the move with time to score. 2.5 left in the second quarter. The fake by Lancaster going back 15 yards. Still looking now. The escape on the right side. A marker's been thrown. The ball tossed out of bounds. A marker in the area of Big Angelo Mosca.
You don't see that happen too often, Don, with Saskatchewan. There was a mix-up in the backfield there with the experience they have back there. And Hamilton now has been called for unnecessary roughness, and I'm sure with that incompletion that the Saskatchewan team will take that penalty and move them again closer to the Hamilton goal line with a first down.
That is a big penalty for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders against Hamilton. Goes inside the 20-yard line. They put the ball down at the 18, and the Riders will go first down from there with 2:17 to play in the first half.
A little experience showing there with Ron Lancaster. He actually was almost throwing that ball away, but he picked a spot where there weren't too many people, but there were a few white sweaters around.
Team fell behind 10-0, and then Ronnie got that short passing game to work, and now Saskatchewan driving late in the second quarter. Campana, Ford, and Barwell all fanned out on the left side. Here's the pitch to George Reed going right behind Clyde Brock. Can't find much of an opening, maybe a yard near the 17. Gary Inskeep, 65, from defensive end. The former Toronto Argonaut and New York Giant filled that hole in quickly.
Little adjustment there on the defense for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. They had that same formation where they have Ford out wide in front of number 17 Rick Shaw, but they moved the cornerback Mike Bloom out on his head, and therefore they wouldn't let them complete that short pass in front of Shaw.
The gain was only a yard. Second and nine to come as that Hamilton defense huddles and now settles in for this play. Is Campana, but he's got to find some yards. He does not have the first down. Stopped at the 12-yard line by Alan Brenner. And Saskatchewan is three away from the first down.
Well, the Hamilton Tiger Cats in a full-out blitz that time with the middle linebacker and one of the outside linebackers coming on, and Ron Lancaster had to throw that ball just a little before he wanted, and Campana wasn't able to get the first down. We'll probably have an attempt at a field goal. Here we have him coming out here now with the blitz on. Campana getting the ball, and then seeing he was surrounded, tried to get the first down, but was 3 yards short.
This will bring on Jack Abinshan, Russ, with Lancaster set to hold for him. Slight angle left from the 20-yard line. This could tie it up. It does. A tie game. Abinshan hitting for the Saskatchewan Roughriders. They've each scored a touchdown via the pass. They've each picked up a field goal, and it is all come the same end of the field against the wind. A minute and 41 seconds until halftime, and there it is, Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. Jack Abinshan, of course, the highest score in Saskatchewan Rough Rider history, adding three more right there. And here's Chuck Ealy getting the tie catch away to the 47-yard line. The strike to Garney Henley, seeing two-way duty at times because of Lewis Porter's injury earlier, and then spelling off Jerry Sternberg from time to time. A busy day for Garney Henley.
A good hit by number 24, Bob Cossett, as Henley caught that ball just curling into the middle against that Saskatchewan zone. And Saskatchewan's going to have to be careful they don't give up too many of those short passes. Otherwise, Hamilton could get close enough to attempt at least a field goal.
Healy wants to lead back by the half. He shot for Buchanan, overthrew him. Bennett back there covering for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Let's go to Johnny Wells now at the Saskatchewan bench.
Don, just talking to Bill Baker, the Saskatchewan Rough Rider defensive end. He was having problems getting through to Chuck Ealy early because the Hamilton Tiger Cats were lining up on the outside, farther on the outside. Baker thinks that they can make some adjustments. The Riders did think that they were going to go to the big blitz early in the game, and they haven't quite made it to Ealy so far. Don?
From the 47, this is second and 10. Ealy rolling, looking. He's got receivers downfield into the medium zone for Garney Henley. 45-yard line, and he tried to get outside. Was caught just in time from the Saskatchewan standpoint by Bob Cossett, because had Henley been able to swing to the left side, he had wide open spaces down the sideline. A minute and two left. The ball is at the 44-yard line, and Hamilton moving.
Well, that's something that Chuck Ealy's been doing all year. Once he starts to scramble a bit, he looks for Henley. And here we see Henley on the isolation. He never quits. He's always looking for an open area. And Chuck Ealy always seems to look for that number 26, Garney Henley.
The game was 19. This is the draw to Buchanan. And in a real traffic jam, contained back at the 49, the loss is five.
Saskatchewan reading those Hamilton draw plays very, very well today. Rock Perdoni, who was with the Ticats last year, number 64, and Charlie Collins, 31, were the two Saskatchewan tacklers.
Well, actually, Don, if any of the defensive linemen take an inside charge on the offensive blocker, there isn't much chance for that draw play to work. And on that particular play, the two inside tackles came to the inside and ran right up, right into the ball carrier, Dave Buchanan.
Healy in trouble, and he'll go down back at the 50-yard line. The loss will be 12. Tim Roth and Bill Baker, the two defensive ends, getting to Chuck Healy. And now we have only 27 seconds left in the second quarter.
A couple of big plays by the Saskatchewan defense. Here we see five of them coming on, putting the rush on Chuck Healy. And the two successive losses that they put on the Hamilton Tiger Cats has put them out of range of any possibility of a field goal. Roth finally getting in there, number 66, to pin Ealy, but all five Saskatchewan defensive players who came on the rush put pressure on Ealy and didn't give him any chance to set up to look downfield for a potential receiver.
On third and 24, number 24, Bob Cossett, and 19, Steve Molnar await the punt from Van Berkelio back at the Saskatchewan 25. Off the side of his foot, a wobbler that bounces at the 25-yard line. Then takes a hop back to the 19 from Molnar, and he's down at the 16-yard line. 3 seconds left that the Saskatchewan Rough Riders will have time for one more play. With the bounce, the kick traveled 40 yards. So it looks as though they'll go into the dressing room at halftime even in this 1972 Grey Cup game. And a reminder again, that great Grey Cup halftime show will be coming up right here. Bob Pierce comes out left. Gord Barwell, 71, to the right side. Thompson and Reed set behind Lancaster for what should be the final play of the first half. It's a handoff to Reed. Swinging right. Met by Angelo Muska, number 68, near the 17-yard line. And that is all for the opening half of the 1972 Canadian Football Championship. The score is Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10.
The Saskatchewan Rough Riders will be sending back Tom Campana, number 17, and Bobby Thompson, number 26, to receive. Waiting for the kickoff from the far hash mark for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, the youngster who turned 19, Ian Sunder, number 36, and the second half is underway. That's Bobby Thompson from the 16-yard line. He was up to the 40 and down to the 42-yard line. Bobby Thompson for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, a 49-yard kickoff and a 26-yard return. A 10-10 ball game, 8 seconds gone in the second half, and there's what happened statistically in the first 30 minutes. Now Saskatchewan will be first and 10 at the Saskatchewan 42-yard line. Lancaster, Reed, Campana, Ford, Barwell, and Thompson. Over to Tom Campana, who breaks to the 55-yard line, keeps fighting all the way into the Hamilton 50. He picks up 18 yards. It is first and 10 for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders.
Well, again, Ronnie Lancaster going to those short men, picking things out. And you'll notice here, Mike Bloom just runs away from this ball, and he's completely out of the play. And Tom Campana just takes it in, and Ronnie Lancaster finds him with one of those little short pro passes.
Saskatchewan Rough Riders going with the wind in the third quarter in a 10-10 ball game. First down at the Hamilton 50. Lancaster, and now we have a mix-up on those receivers as we had Barwell and Thompson both down there, and the ball was well in between them. What a great day. Great to be a Canadian, to watch a great Canadian show with a halftime show that just is the best that the Grey Cup Championship has ever seen, and many adjectives have been used, and we'd like to add ours as a special thanks to the people of Hamilton. It was sensational. Second and 10, Saskatchewan at the 50. Out there to Campana, lost his balance down to the 46-yard line. Tried to recover, but had to settle for four. Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Club that didn't do much blitzing earlier, did today.
Well, again, Ronnie Lancaster going with the short stuff. You notice he's able to throw that ball a little off balance, and Campana unable to hold his feet. You always try and cut back against the grain because you know that that defensive back is going to go across you. If you can get him to go across and come around, you can pick up that extra yardage. Couldn't hold his footing on this one.
Third down and six for the Saskatchewan Roughriders, and Pierce just got that off its tip that went over the line of scrimmage. And Saskatchewan has to give yards. They didn't. The flag is down. Bob Krause has recovered. And so that ball, even though it was tipped, wound up with a total 4 yards.
Well, we talk about quarterbacks only having certain time to throw that ball. Kickers are the same way. Lewis Porter was the one that came in from the outside. He has the farthest distance to go, but he's able to use that speed to his advantage, get a piece of that football, and then the Hamilton Tiger Cats recover on it.
Even though that ball was tipped, and even though it just got across the line of scrimmage, even if it goes only a half a yard over the line of scrimmage, you must give the no yards, and that, of course, was the penalty. You saw Saskatchewan backpedaling, trying to get away from the ball, but they were simply trapped. And so Hamilton takes over, first and 10, at the Hamilton 53-yard line. Buchanan. And Buchanan is hit by Rock Perdone, Don Benuke, and Wayne Shaw. And he just got over that line of scrimmage. Might have picked up about a yard on the play, maybe even less than that. Dave Buchanan has now carried the ball 11 times for a total of 23 yards. And he's only the second Tiger Cat to ever go over 1,000 yards in one season. Jerry McDougal was the other. Second down. Haley. Down the center, and it's good to Garney Henley, and he's up to the 38-yard line. Big first down for Garney Henley, 18 yards.
Well, let's take a look at the Shenley Award winner, Garney Henley, on isolation. And when you have a zone defense, your defensive backs have got to react more to that ball as it leaves the quarterback's hand. You notice here that he's able to take it in. Just a little curl-in pattern, not really pretty as far as running a pattern's concerned, but it's effective.
And so Hamilton moved to the Saskatchewan 38, first and 10. Healy steps back out of that pocket. And is finally pulled down by Sweetak, and there's a flag on the play. A clipping penalty is being called. Chuck Healy, who had a sensational 65 streak going.
Well, Chuck Healy again, he had a couple of men open, but look how he fakes that little looking downfield, going to pump it, and then he takes off with it. He tries to set up a block here with that little fake to the outside, but Dave Fleming has called for blocking from the rear on Bob Cossett. That's going to cost him about 15 yards.
Ball is going to be marched back. There's the indication of the clipping penalty. And the referee, Don Barker of Vancouver, that'll bring it back 15. Coming back from the original line of scrimmage at the 38-yard line. There's the indication of the clipping penalty again by the referee. It'll bring the ball back to the 53-yard line. It'll be first down over again and 25 yards to go. 11:53 remaining in the third quarter of a 10-10 ball game. Porter now out there as a wide flanker. Healy. Hit by Wayne Shaw, knocked off balance, and Ted Tuschinski drives him out. Two former Saskatoon Hilltops teaming up to hold him to a gain of 2. Hamilton Tiger Cats turning an interception and a blocked kick into 10 points in the first half. Saskatchewan marching back at a 75-yard drive and then kicking the field goal. Jack Abenshine made it a 10-10 ball game. Second and 23 for the Hamilton Tiger Cats at the Saskatchewan 52. Healy getting a lot of time to throw to Henley, and he does not hold on. And Roy Robinson made a sensational recovery because Garney Henley, for a fraction of a second, had his hands on it, but not long enough to squeeze it.
Well, it looked like he was going to put that one in his hip pocket, going for the bomb on this play. Chuck Ealy looking to one side. That's a good quarterbacking job there. Looking to one side, coming back to the man, Gurney Henley. And as you mentioned, Roy Robinson making a big play. I'm really surprised, though. We've gone through the a whole half of a football game, and I don't think we've seen a screen pass. And you'd think that they would be doing that. There you got a chance to see it again from a different angle. Notice that ball just knocked away.
And the third and 23 from Van Berkelio. Kick is taken by Steve Mulder, and Mulder is down on the 19-yard line. 34-yard kick and a 3-yard return. So the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, who have the wind in this third quarter, a club that has met the Hamilton Tiger Cats 4 times in Grey Cups, 4 times they've lost to Hamilton in Grey Cups, and they dearly doubt to break that jinx today. First down at the 20. Lancaster to George Reed, and he is knocked off balance as George Wells turned him back inside. Just got enough of his shoulder on her and dropped him. The score is Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment.
With the way the momentum of the game is going, you got Bob Pierce in your backfield. He was a quarterback in his days, and I know in practice watching him this week that he can throw that football. It might not be a bad opportunity to go with that halfback option.
Well, I'm sure that each club has put a couple of those in that they haven't unveiled too often during the season, and they'll wait for the right moment. Now Saskatchewan, second and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They have the wind. And there it is to Bobby Pierce. Look at this get scramble. He lost his balance on the 50-yard line because that might have been the same one. But when this season opened here on July 31st, he did that one all the way with it.
Well, I got half of it right. It was Bob Pierce anyway, even though it wasn't the halfback option. But Ronnie Lancaster looking to the outside, and then Bob Pierce taking it down and sort of squaring it across the middle, getting it inside of his receiver, and then putting that second effort on it to make a real fine reception.
31-yard gain, and the Saskatchewan Rough Riders are first down at their own 50. 10-10 ball game, 9:48 remaining in the third quarter. Reed, and Reed is met right at the line of scrimmage. The all-time great rusher in the CFL. And two coaches who were formerly Coach of the Year, Jerry Williams in 1967 and Dave Scrine back in 1964. Second down and 9.5 yards to go. Saskatchewan at the Saskatchewan 50. Lancaster has to hurry that throw, and it's pulled down at the 46-yard line. There's a flag on the play. The pass is ruled incomplete. They ruled that he trapped the ball. And there might have been an interference call going downfield. Bob Pierce, 185-pound versatile back, does everything for them.
John, what happens? You find that your defensive backs give you the inside a little bit, and here they had that sort of switching pattern on again, and he was unable to complete the pass, but there was interference on the play on the far side, so they pick up the gain anyway.
That moved the ball to the Hamilton Tiger Cat 48-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders as they are leading trainer in years of service, Sandy Archer, looks on at the Saskatchewan bench. Thompson. Bobby Thompson, number 26, into the 41-yard line, gaining 7 yards on the play. Thompson for Saskatchewan scored 7 touchdowns this year, but all of them were on the pass. Second down, 3 yards to go for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. In a 10-10 ball game, 8:23 remaining in the third quarter. Now Barwell, Ford, Campana all set out to the left. Thompson and Bobby Pierce to the right. George Reed, and Reed is hit behind the line, and he is dropped. Tried to follow the blocking in there of Gary Brandt,
Brandt was cut off, and he was held right at the line of scrimmage, so it'll be third down and three, and that'll bring out Jack Abinshan. Now, the line of scrimmage is the 41. Abinshan's longest field goal this season was 48 yards. It's a 10-10 ball game. Saskatchewan kicking with the win. Abinshan now has 671 points. That makes him the third all-time scorer in the CFL. No good. It's wide. Clark. And he is driven out at the 8-yard line. Clark, wanting to prove to Saskatchewan that he's a good ball player, went to their camp and didn't make it. The score is Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. It's a 10-10 ball game, and we have 7:37 remaining in the third quarter. The Hamilton Tiger Cats. Mitchell at center, Chalupka and Holman, the all-star guards. Gant. Danichuk the tackles. And Buchanan is met by Rock Perdoni. Renzo Rock Perdoni, who was brought up, the All-American from Georgia, brought up by Hamilton and cut. Winnipeg, Edmonton, and then he replaced the great Ed McWhorters when McWhorters went out with the knee operation late in the 1972 campaign. Second down and 10.5 yards to go. Now they have Henley split to the left. Coffey and Lewis Porter wide to the right. Ronnie gets some heat on, but the pass is taken by Fleming. Is caught in there by number 60 for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, Don Banyuk. He got very close to that first down territory. And they don't have to bring the sticks very far to find out. But
well, you're going to... You see a good defensive rush here by Bill Baker, but the ball has gotten away to Fleming. But notice the second effort that Fleming puts forth. He's nailed back upfield, and he has to dive for about 3 yards to make sure that they got that first down. A big play.
Give him 11 yards on the play. It'll be first and 10 now for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. The ball is at the Hamilton 20-yard line. Side open up. Look at him go. And he finally lost his balance and was dropped at the 39-yard line. Chuck Ealy. Picks up 19 yards along the way.
Well, John, I'm not really convinced this fellow's a quarterback, although he's back there passing the ball, because he's got the moves of any good halfback. You look how he's throwing his shoulders, weight all around, and balance as well.
And he's picked up 51 yards running so far this afternoon. First down as the toss goes to Buchanan. And Buchanan has trouble trying to get to the outside as Roy Robinson and Ted Dushinsky come up to stop him for a gain of four. Well, this 1972 season opened right here in Hamilton. It was Hamilton beating Saskatchewan 20-17 on a last-minute field goal. Bob Pierce and Lewis Porter gave us some heroics that day. Right now we have 5:25 remaining in the third quarter. It's a 10-10 ball game, and Hamilton is second down and five at their own 44. Gets outside the rush again, and he hits Granny Henley. Henley faked to the inside, turned to the outside, didn't have any room to go. The sideline was right there, but he picked up 13 yards.
Well, again, let's take a look at Garney Henley as he goes down, just looks to the inside. That's a real good fake to the inside. I think he noticed that the quarterback was rushed on the play and he was going to the outside, so he went to an open spot. Real good receiver will do.
Henley has caught five for 78 yards, and the Tiger Cats are first and 10 at the Saskatchewan 54. Going against a 15-mile-an-hour wind. The toss to Buchanan, and he's hit in there by Wayne Shaw, number 50. Then he got a little bit of help in there from Don Banyuk. He just got about a yard over the line of scrimmage. Having an opportunity to see two ball players do a lot of two-way action, Henley and Porter. They're both out there as wide flankers now. Second down, 9.5 yards to go for the Tiger Cats. Healy goes to Henley, and Henley hit by Charlie Collins. Those Rough Riders are putting a little something extra in each of those tackles now, Dick. The gain is 8. It'll be third down and about 1.5 yards to go. Jerry Williams, known as one of the most conservative coaches of the year.
Well, we'll show you what John was talking about when we mentioned the fact a little extra effort put in at number 31, Charlie Collins. He's the man that comes up and makes a tackle on this play. Watch that right arm. Oh, missed his head, but he's down anyway.
Jerry Williams not taking any chances in a 10-10 ball game with 1.5 yards to go. Sends Bill Van Berkelio to his own 50. Saskatchewan has Molnar and Cossett back to receive. Molnar at his own 4-yard line. He hit by Tony Gabriel and dropped at the 5-yard line. That's a 42-yard kick and a 3-yard return. So the Saskatchewan Rough Riders come out onto the field, read by Ronnie Lancaster. Probably when he went there in 1963, might have been the biggest bargain in the history of sport for $350. They've never missed the playoffs since. Now Saskatchewan, first down at their own 5-yard line. 3:34 to go in this third quarter. Thompson trying to get outside with Jack Abincham, but the best he can do is get up to that 7-yard line. Like I mentioned earlier, that Dave Scryan was the coach of the year in 64. He was coach of the year in 63. Not to mind by the fact that Frank Clair is the only coach to become coach of the year to win the Grey Cup the same year as Russ Jackson was the only man to win the Shenley Award and win the Grey Cup the same year. Second down, 7 yards to go at the 8. Oops. Doyle Greed. And he's cut right off. Bruce Smith is in there to grab him, but the flags are down. Still a 10-10 ball game as it was at the half.
Well, we'll show you that back again. A lot of times your line, especially in a crowd like this, a lot of your outside men can't hear the cadence of the quarterback. In this particular case, Clyde Brock, number 67 on the right side, was the one that came across, and they were caught. Naturally, the Hamilton defense was up for that one, so they're not going to bother with the penalty.
The score, Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10, the 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. Ball is at the 6.5, 7-yard line. It is third down and 8.5 yards to go. The Saskatchewan Rough Riders with 2:43 left to play with the wind. Now, strangely enough, that Hamilton defense has been able to stay real tough on George Reed. And in the last 4 carries, they have been able to hold George Reed to a loss of 2 yards. Third down, 8.5 yards to go. And Bob Pierce is about 8 yards back in his own end zone. That was almost blocked. Might have even been tipped. The ball is taken by Sternberg, and there's a no-yards penalty called, and the Hamilton Tiger Cats will take over at the 33, and they'll add another 10 to it.
Well, we're going to take another look at this one. This is the third kick that the Hamilton Tiger Cats have had a piece of today. Here you have a split-screen look at the receivers and also the defensive man going in. It's Bob Krause who got a piece of that football. And then, of course, the Jerry Sternberg was able to pick it up. And no yards called, so Hamilton's got it in great field position.
And so the Hamilton Tiger Cats are first down at the Saskatchewan Rough Rider 26.5-yard line. Healy. Chased from behind by Tim Roth, throwing long down there, and it is knocked. It's intercepted. Roy Robinson
What a sensational interception. Brings it out to the 16-yard line. That's one of the great ones.
Well, Bob Richardson is just wide open in the end zone. Ely sees him, and then he fires the ball to him. The only trouble is he doesn't really have that much on the football. He's trying to get it down there to him, and the ball has just popped loose. You take a look for yourself. You notice he's scrambling around there. He finds Richardson. He has to throw off balance. That's why there's not much on it. And then Ted Jashinski knocks the ball loose. Roy Robinson picks it up.
Saskatchewan at the 16-yard line, first and 10. As Lancaster looks away out there, and he's got Tom Campana up to the 26. Stopped eventually at the 27-yard line, Tom Campana.
We might have seen just the top play of the whole ball game, John, because that play would have meant 6 points for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, and here Saskatchewan ends up with it.
Saskatchewan picking up 11 yards, and the ball is at the 27-yard line, and it is first and 10 for the Riders. 1:14 remaining in the third quarter. Lancaster, and he hits Allen Ford. The ball pops loose. Ford was hit by a rickshaw and Al Brenner together, and that's a pretty good hit with those two coming. Pretty tough to hold on to the ball in that kind of a crowd.
John, as you look at the Grey Cup records, you look at Allen Ford, and he holds two. He holds the longest punt record of 87 yards in the 67 Grey Cup, and he also holds the longest kickoff return, 78 yards in the 69 Grey Cup. His father was an old Regina Rough Rider back in the 20s.
Second down and 10 to go for Saskatchewan at the 27. Lancaster looking over there to Tom Campana, and finally Mark Cosmos drives him out at the 47-yard line. Big first down as this 13-year veteran Ron Lancaster sits back there and starts picking his spots.
Well, Tom Campana, just the most valuable player on this ball club, because when there's work to be done, Campana's usually the one, whether it be kickoff return or having to go down under a reception or carry the ball from the halfback position. A very valuable asset to these Rough Riders out of Ohio State.
First down at the Saskatchewan Rough Rider 47-yard line. George Reed keeps driving. Look at him carry Al Brenner down to the 53-yard line, and that's very, very close to a first down. And some of the distinguished guests at the 1972 Grey Cup game, the commissioner, Jake Adair, Ralph Sazier right behind him, the outstanding coach. It's just this Hamilton club over the years, now the part owner, Bill Clark of Regina, the president of the CFL, Premier Davis. The ambassador from Finland is here today. We were talking to him. He said he was in Toronto, and Lincoln Alexander said he would find a seat for him, and he did. So they're coming from all over.
John, you know, when you get into important ball games, you get pretty protective, and you want to hide out your ball club. It even happens in high school. Notice that Beamsville down the road here was playing Dennis Morris in a game, and they were so protective they wanted to keep the everybody away from it. And after this play, I'll get back and tell you the rest of that story.
First down, Saskatchewan at the Hamilton 52-yard line. Thompson, and Thompson is hit by Mike Blumendrop. First door was closed. He tried to find a second, and Mike Bloom didn't give it to him.
I was telling you about the schools playing down the road here. They noticed a car at the end of the road, a guy with binoculars in it. They went down, shook the car, and told the guy to get out. I want to know who it is. It ended up it was Jerry Williams there to see his son Todd practice. He didn't want to interfere.
Second down and 10.5 yards to go, Saskatchewan. A good rush on Lancaster this time. Has to unload. It's intercepted. Jerry Sternberg brings it up to the 52-yard line. The Hamilton Tiger Cats pick another one off. That ends the third quarter. Score Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. Saskatchewan held the ball for 8 minutes and 12 seconds during that quarter, and Hamilton 6:48.
There's the last part of that play. It was a full blitz on, so your defensive backs have to pay up and play their man for man. Played a little tighter. Jerry Sternberg, anticipating the play, is able to pick off the ball for Hamilton.
Hamilton starts this fourth quarter, first and 10 at their own 51. The toss is to Fleming. And Fleming is caught in there by Rock Perdoni, number 64, and he's dropped after a gain of 3 or 4 yards on the play. Dave Fleming has carried the ball 5 times for a total of 17 yards.
Well, the Rock, when Rock Perdoni, is the fact that he isn't able to get in on a pass rush and get in there and use that height to his advantage to knock passes down, but certainly as well as the, as far as the lateral movement's concerned, you can't fault him in that department.
Second down and 7 yards to go for the Cats at the 53. Healy puts a long look in there to Dave Fleming. Now they're going to be forced to bring out the kicking unit. Chuck Healy had, it took a long, long time to get that one out. Total possession in the ball game is very, very close. Hamilton has had the ball for almost just 23 minutes. Saskatchewan just over 22. So the score indicates the share of the offensive play. On this third down and 7 situation, Van Berkley at his own 40. Almost blocked in there by Tim Roth. That's Steve Molnar at the 15-yard line. Gord Christian had a piece of him, lost him, and then dropped him back at the 14. That's a 41-yard kick and a loss of 2 on the return. The Hamilton Tiger Cats, a team that has won 11 Eastern Championships and 5 Grey Cups in the past 20 years. They're in for the 12th time, which ties Toronto Argonauts for most appearances in the Grey Cup Championship. Saskatchewan Roughriders going against a 15-mile-an-hour wind. Will scrimmage first and 10 at the Saskatchewan 14-yard line. Barwell and Pierce split wide. George Reed. And they go to the 21-yard line, carrying 2 ball players with him, Jerry Sternberg and the defensive end, George Wells, an all-star in the Eastern Conference. George Reed now has 83 yards. He holds just about every rushing record there is. Second down and 3 yards to go for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Come right back again with a 10-year veteran, George Reed, and that's very, very close to a first down. It may require the yardsticks. Strangely enough, Dick, that wind hasn't meant that much, hasn't been much of a factor today.
No, it hasn't, because we've seen a lot of the scoring done while we've had going against the wind. You know, this Hamilton Defensive Club is really something. They're really a together unit. And you talk to Angie Mosca, he can tell you just how much so they are. And especially when you get together and you talk about the defensive unit. He talks about Smith and Wells on the outside. He says, introduce these two fellas together because they share one brain together. And then he talks about number 65, Inskeep, on the other side, his fellow that is beside him. He says, call him Thumbtacks. He's got legs like Thumbtacks.
Saskatchewan has a first down at the Saskatchewan 24-yard line in a 10-10 ball game. Lancaster to Reed, and Reed is met in there by Mark Cosmos. Now he might lose a yard on the play. Mark Cosmos, 242-pound, has just made his 6th unassisted tackle. He's made assists on 2, so he's been in on 8. He took exception to a remark that we made earlier in the season that he might not be big enough to stop inside running. He said, we'll show you. Second down and 10 at the Saskatchewan 24. Oh, that big blitz is on, and the pass was almost intercepted. There's a flag on the play. They were trying to screen George Reed. And in order to break up that screen, I think that Hamilton jumped the gun.
Well, you see the rush from the ground level there. All those middle linemen, the only thing it didn't show you was just that the left part of your screen was that old Thumbtacks, Gary Inkeep, was offside on the play by about 10 yards.
Thumbtacks at 258 pounds. Second down and 5 yards to go for Saskatchewan at their own 29-yard line.
11:32 to play. Lancaster way out there to Thompson, and he does not have it. Ooh, he had a ton of space. That'll make it third and five.
Boy, those are the ones that drive you crazy. That ball just hangs up there, and you keep waiting for it to get to you. It's just floating down there, and he sort of tries to jump up in the air and grab the thing. He's so anxious he wants to get a hold of it, and consequently, your hands are like boards. You just can't hold on to it.
Back to receive the fine punt return pair of Jerry Sternberg, number 33, and Dave Clark, number 15. They each dropped one on the opening game of the season here, and then between them only dropped once during the rest of the year. That was, boy, that was close to being blocked. They're getting tremendous rush. Clark at the 43. And he hit there by Don Seaman, number 79. 38-yard kick and a 2-yard return. A fine Saskatoon product, Don Seaman. The score is Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment. The great veteran Angelo Mosca says this is his last game as a professional football player. A defensive conference going on with Jerry Williams, who converted this club from a club that used to rely on defensive giants that committed mayhem to a club that added a lot of finesse, high scoring, and record crowds and attendance here at Hamilton this year. The Ticats are first and 10 at their own 45-yard line. Healy, he steps back inside that hole. Hit by Charlie Collins and then regained his balance and went out at the midfield stripe, and that should be enough for the first down. Chuck Healy, probably the, well, I think he's the greatest rookie ever to play in the CFL. Just a sensational year.
Well, again, you get a chance to see Chuck Healy as he shows you that he knows what he's doing all the time. He knows where that yard mark is as he tries to come around this side and run right into you. Just jumping over that yard mark to get that first down.
Hamilton first and 10 at midfield. 10:31 remaining in the ballgame. A 10-10 score. Healy over the center, and it is no good. Intended for Garney Henley, and Roy Robinson was there to almost pick it off. Henley, the all-time scorer in college football with his record of 394 points, said last year at the end of the year he hoped to play one more year so that maybe he'd get a chance to play offense, and what a chance he's had. Lewis Porter comes in. Now it'll be Porter, number 24, who'll go to the top of your screen, and Henley, 26, right there at the bottom. Second and 10. There's the long one down there for Porter, and it's intercepted by Lewis Cook. Here he comes, number 16, looking for blocking. And he comes all the way to the 50-yard line. There's a flag in the play, and didn't that look like the one he pulled off against Winnipeg? There's a clipping penalty.
Well, we were isolating here, or taking a look at Lewis Porter. As we look at it from the end zone, notice Chuck Healy, the play was sent in from the bench. Lewis Porter's going down deep, a post pattern, but Lewis Cook is there to intercept the ball. He takes it back upfield, but number 64, Rock Perdoni, is called there. As you noticed, the body's going by. Here you get a chance to see Lewis Porter as he goes down deep, and Lewis Cook anticipating his move, just laying back there and making the play. There, right there, as the player went by, that was Rock Perdoni getting caught for clipping.
Saskatchewan first down at the Saskatchewan 26-yard line. 9:38 remaining in the ball game. They give to George Reed, and Reed is hit by Cosmos and number 61, Bruce Smith. Bruce Smith played for Jerry Williams in Philadelphia, and then phoned up one day and asked for a tryout, and Hamilton came up and has become his starting defensive tackle the day he arrived. Second down and 9 yards to go. Saskatchewan at their own 27. Over here to Gordon Barwell. And he's up to the 35-yard line. He's about a yard short of a first down in a very crucial position. He kept digging and fighting, and he's still complaining to the referee that they didn't move it as far as he thought it had been.
Well, those defensive backs are still playing these offensive men back awfully deep. They're just giving them too much room. And, of course, Ronnie Lancaster going up the line of scrimmage. He notices how deep they're lined up. So, consequently, he automatics at the line and just goes with the short stuff. Okay, Bob.
John, Hamilton has been very successful against that Saskatchewan punt, and I talked to four members of the defensive line, and they all said the same thing. It's just straight, aggressive blocking and rushing by those front four and the outside linebackers and nothing else. No tricks.
Okay, third down and a yard to go. Saskatchewan. George Reed, and Reed looks like he's over the 35-yard line, and that should be enough for the first down. Charlie Collins rushes off the field, holding his hand in the air, saluting victory for George Reed. We have 8 minutes and 35 seconds left on the clock.
Hey, you just got to see the last part of the power that George Reed had. You had all 12 men bunched in there just ready to stop anything that came through. But when you get George Reed with a full head of steam and got that body moving forward with those legs grinding it out, it's pretty hard to stop him from gaining a yard.
For those who believe in omens, the Saskatchewan, at least the Hamilton Tiger Cats, made great comebacks in 1959, 61, and 64, and then they proceeded to lose all three of those Grey Cups. Right now, Saskatchewan is first down at the Saskatchewan 36. This is Bobby Thompson. And he is cut off from behind by Bob Krause, number 14. Just got over the line of scrimmage. Might have picked up a yard. Bob Krause, a 9-year veteran who came right out of Central High School in Hamilton to the Tiger Cats, and he's calling their defensive signals for them. 8 minutes, 2 seconds left in the ball game. Second down, 9 yards to go. Saskatchewan at the Saskatchewan 37. Here to Barwell again, and he holds on to this one as he's hit by Mike Bloom, and he leans forward this time. And they moved the ball back. They moved the ball back, so again, they're going to be third down at about 2 feet to go.
I guess the officials are going to cut back on what I'd mentioned in one of our broadcasts earlier, the fact that according to surveys, any game played on artificial turf, you pick up an extra 10 to 20 yards because of the players bouncing off of the artificial turf.
Gordon Barwell has caught 5 for 44 yards today. Strangely enough, Bobby Thompson, who caught 51 during the season, was the leading receiver for Saskatchewan, has not caught a pass. Now, Saskatchewan is not going to gamble. Bob Pierce is back to do the kicking. A wobbler up. Dave Clark watches it go, and it goes out. Oh, no, it curled back in, and he is driven out of there by Rob Pine, number 15. A 46-yard kick. So rookie Rob Pine scores Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues. In Henley and coming to the right this time. Gabriel Richardson and Coffey to the left. Healy to the sideline, and it's good to the 37-yard line, and that is going to be a gain of 17 yards. Tommy Joe Coffey, the all-time leading scorer in the CFL with 971 points. Picked up 17 to the 36. Tiger Cats with 6:49 remaining. They're looking to get down to kicking territory this late in the game. Oh, that rush is on Ely by Wayne Shaw. Turns it back in. Here's the pass out there to Buchanan. He's got it. Dave Buchanan. And there's a flag on the play. Buchanan makes a great catch, and I believe the call is for clipping.
Well, you could see that play coming, Buzz. Buchanan
had to swing out of the backfield. Now what happens is the middle linebacker, number 51, Steve Switak, has to go over and cover him. Well, he committed himself too much so that the quarterback, Ely, was able to lead him. You notice him laying back there on the ground. Buchanan takes the ball in. The only trouble is it was a pretty play and has to come back.
15-yard penalty for clipping. Makes a total of 67 yards in penalties. And that puts the ball back at the 37-yard line. It'll be first down and 10. 6 minutes and 20 seconds left in the ball game. Buchanan again hit by Rock Perdoni. It came over from left tackle. He just drove him right across with Don Banuka on the right side, and the gain is about 1 yard. Lewis Porter comes in, Bob Richardson goes out.
John, we should explain the fact that the play was completed, but Tommy Joe Coffey was caught for clipping on it, and that's why it had to come back, but it still was first down over again.
Second down and 9 yards to go. Hamilton Tiger Cats at their own 38-yard line. There's Ely throwing out there to Porter, and Porter is dropped at the 49-yard line. He had Tommy Joe Coffey out there. He took a quick look at him to see if he could try a little bit of a lateral, but he thought he better hold on.
Well, they learned by their last mistake. Instead of going deep, they sent Lewis Porter down on the same pattern, only this time when he got back, he hooked up about 15 yards and completed the pass.
Okay,
let's go down to John Wells.
Thanks, Johnny. Just talking to a couple of members of the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. They know they're in a football game down here. Don Seelan was telling me it's one of the hardest hitting football games he's been in. I'm sure it's evident on the screen.
First down, Hamilton at the 49. And here's that rush on Ely. And they've got him back there at the 54-yard line. He almost shook loose with that tremendous physical ability of his and got back up to the Saskatchewan 54. Now the clock shows 4 minutes and 46 seconds left.
John, as you measure these two quarterbacks on their statistics, they're holding true. They're pretty even as far as the long gainer is concerned, the number of touchdown passes. The big story is interceptions. Lancaster threw 20 during the year. Ely only 8. That's been holding true. And losses. Ely had 38 during the year. Ronnie Lancaster, 6.
Hamilton is second down and 15 yards to go at the 54. Ely caught now and dropped. Bruce Bennett slowed him down, and finally Bill Manchuk, number 75, came in. Manchuk had just come in to replace Wayne Shaw, and they dropped him. That'll make it third down and about 14 yards to go. Well, with 4 minutes and 14 seconds on the clock, we'll have Don Chevrier and Russ Jackson warming up just in case it should go into that first session of overtime. Bill Van Berkelio from his own 44. Steve Molnar back to the 6-yard line, and he lost his balance as Gord Christian was in on top of him, and he's dropped at the 7. 47-yard kick and a 2-yard return. Bill Van Berkelio, who had averaged 39 and a half during the season, come up with a 47-yarder when he really needed it. So this jam-packed audience of 35,000 at Ivor Wynne Stadium witnessing a tense 10-10 battle. Hamilton went on top by 10. Now Saskatchewan first down at their own 7. George Reed. Reed dives in underneath the pile to about the 13-yard line. And Saskatchewan all afternoon has been faced with second down long yardage situations. Second down and 5 yards to go for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. They're at their own 12-yard line. Lancaster over the middle to Tom Campana to the 21-yard line, catching it under tremendous pressure, and Campana has taken him out of a hole many times. Maybe a lot of winners here today. The Manitoba Sports Lottery Group, one of them is going to win $100,000 on the game. The score is Saskatchewan 10 and Hamilton 10. The 1972 Grey Cup game continues in just a moment.
You know, that gang of 2,900 out of Regina has kind of infected this crowd, and I think they're getting more support than Hamilton right now. First and 10, Saskatchewan at the Saskatchewan 21-yard line. Lancaster out there to Tom Campana. Broke the first tackle, goes to the 26. He picked up 5 yards on the play. 2 minutes and 45 seconds left, and in the event of the score being tied, they would then go into overtime, of course.
There you're taking a look at Rick Shaw, who's been having a busy day all afternoon. A lot of people forget that he was a leading receiver for Winnipeg back in 1970, shifted to defense.
Second down and 5 to go for Saskatchewan.
Oh, and Lancaster slips and falls, throws down here for Bobby Pearson. He's got it. Down to the 48-yard line. What a great play. Lancaster slipped and fell, got up and threw the pass for 36 yards to Bobby Pierce.
Well, Bobby Pierce is blessed with that good speed that he can get behind his backs. And there you take a look at him on isolation as he gets down there, and then he just turns it on behind Lewis Porter. And he's got his eye on the ball all the way, and he's able to anticipate the defensive man's move and move in front of it to make the completion.
Saskatchewan first down at the Hamilton 48-yard line. Oh, the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage. It was intended for Al Ford. It'll be second down and 10 to go. Al Ford, the 8-year veteran. Lancaster has thrown 28, completed 20.
There you see Ronnie Lancaster. He's a short quarterback, and once those linemen get their hands up there, and there's big Angie Mosca. He jumps up there and knocks that ball down.
Second and 10 for the Saskatchewan Rough Riders at the Hamilton 48. Oh, that was intended for Gordon Barwell, but it was almost picked as Al Brenner was back there, and now Saskatchewan will be forced to kick on third and 10. As I said, in the event of a tie, the teams will be allowed to go to the dressing room for 10 minutes, and then an overtime game of 2 10-minute halves will be played, with the ball being kicked off at the commencement of each half, and the team which had the choice at the beginning of the regular game will again have the choice at the start of the overtime game. 10-10 the score. 2 minutes left to go. Bob Pierce kicking from the Saskatchewan 50. Clark at the 12-yard line. He's almost slipped through that pocket, but then Rob Pine dropped him. It's interesting to note Rob Pine, the son of Wayne Pine, one of the great Saskatchewan Rough Rider players in bygone days, playing against Ian Sutter. They played against each other in the junior final this last year, right on the same field. Now we have 1 minute, 51 seconds left. Saskatchewan, a club that has never beaten Hamilton in 4 Grey Cup tries, and I have to hold him in here. Healy over the center, and it's good there to Tony Gabriel for his first catch of the day. Up to the 43-yard line for a gain of 27 yards.
Well, Tony Gabriel, and I believe that's his first reception of the day, he just goes down the middle and he gets behind everybody, and it's wide open. They get the zone defense where everybody was back deep, afraid that they're going to go deep on him. They're going to have to watch the short stuff, though, because all Hamilton has to do is move down the field with the short stuff for the last try at the kick.
First down at the Hamilton 42-yard line, and this game has gone wild. Over the middle here to Tony Gabriel. And Gabriel has another first down for 11 yards. 1 minute and 15 seconds left on the clock, and the panel try to choose the outstanding player of the game, and the outstanding Canadian of the game have not done so. The outstanding player will receive the Labatt Award and a new car. The outstanding Canadian will be honored with the Dick Suderman Award by Canadian Pacific, 2 trips anywhere. First down at the Hamilton 54-yard line. Heaney rushed, throws out there, but he throws low. Intended for Dave Buchanan. And there we have the 10-10 ball game. 58 seconds remaining. Chuck Ealy has completed 16 out of 27 for 259 yards. Ronnie Lancaster has completed 20 out of 28. Super day of quarterbacking. Great defenses to meet it. Second and 10 at the Hamilton 54. Ealy again over the middle. Let's get to Tony Gabriel, and he's down to the 42-yard line. 51 seconds left in the ball game. 15-yard gain for Tony Gabriel, who picked up his third catch of the day. Now has 53 yards.
Well, what's happened is that the end is getting free. The linebackers are not dropping back deep enough and covering their area. Notice Steve Svitek there just sort of gliding back and then reacting to the ball, but that's too late. Your deep men have to be deep because they're afraid of getting burnt. So consequently, Chuck Ealy is going with the short stuff and working it down the field, working Tony Gabriel to his advantage.
Lewis Cook with the injured ankle. And this could be very costly for Saskatchewan because the Hamilton Tiger Cats, now with 51 seconds left in the ball, you have plenty of time to figure out what their remaining strategic offense might be. Saskatchewan Rough Riders.
Chuck Ealy trying to get his last instructions as to what plays to call there from Jerry Williams while Sandy Archer works on Lewis Cook. That is really a cramp in his calf. And what happens in a game like this when you sweat so much, if you can believe sweating in 20-degree weather, that you lose all the salt in your system. That's why a lot of the players take salt tablets all the time to keep from getting these cramps. But not much you can do if it tightens up on you. The only thing you can do is try and relax and let him work it out.
And just while we have a moment, it has been said before, but on behalf of football fans everywhere, we'd like to congratulate Mayor Vic Copps and Breakup Committee Chairman Jack McDonald, because they have done an outstanding job, just a super job of putting it together. The city of Hamilton has turned out, the official attendance here is 33,953.
John, if we could get our cameras to take a shot of some of the posters that are up on the lampposts that are around the stadium, these posters that are up by the lampposts that were made by the high school students here in Hamilton, that were painted by the different high school students. There you get a shot of one. These are huge things. They've just done an outstanding job of it, of decorating the stadium.
Well, Tom Campana is out there with Cossid, Bennett, Dushinsky, and Robinson. And they catch him at the 41-yard line, Ealy. Second down and about 8.5 yards to go. To catch that rejuggled Saskatchewan defensive backfield out there for you. The clock shows 42 seconds remaining. There's Jerome Gant, the right tackle.
Well, Tom Campana was a defensive back at Ohio State, but he's got that ability to play offense, so they shifted him to the offense here in
Saskatchewan. Second down, 8.5 yards to go. Over the middle there, and it is good to the 26-yard line. That was Garney Henley. Made a great catch. 16 yards was the length of the gain, and it was second and long yardage. Garney Henley has 8 catches for 119 yards.
Well, another big play, as you notice it on split screen. Garney Henley running his pattern. He's got to be completely off balance, slipping, coming back to grab that ball. Charlie Collins was squawking the fact that he felt that he had dropped the ball, but the official was right there, ruled it's a completed pass, ball on the 26-yard line.
First and 10 for Hamilton at the Saskatchewan 26. It's Buchanan, the ball carrier. He's dropped for a loss of one, but they're going to be staying very close to those goalposts. Now, will it be Ian Sutter, or will they try one more? There's only 13 seconds left. They're not going to wait. Well, if this field goal is good, it would be a new record because only two have been kicked in a Grey Cup game. And now the line of scrimmage will be the 27-yard line. If it's wide, will they return the kick? Saskatchewan has Al Ford back there along with Bob Pierce, two punters. Henley will hold. They'll try from the 34. It's good. And that'll be it, the last play of the game. The Hamilton Tiger Cats on the last play of the game kick the field goal to beat the Saskatchewan Rough Riders 13-10. Young Ian Sutter, the pride of Dundee, Scotland, has been under tremendous pressure all year. Came through under tremendous pressure again and kicked the field goal to make it five straight Grey Cup wins for Hamilton over Saskatchewan. And what a heartbreaking end for Saskatchewan. What a glorious end for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, the two teams that started the season here on July the 31st. I've ended it here on December the 3rd. And one of the most thrilling Grey Cup games that we've ever had the privilege of attending.
Well, job, just an outstanding job by Ian Sutter. Certainly it was set up by some great plays by the whole Hamilton Tiger Cat offense and defense. And you summed it up very well. I thought Saskatchewan certainly doesn't have to hang their head. It was just an outstanding football game by both clubs, both offensively and defensively. And I don't think you could ask for anything more in a national Grey Cup final than what we've seen today.
Well, Angie Mosca, after 15 years, is going out in great style. Garney Henley, number 26, the outstanding player, Henley Award winner in 1972, down there to accept the trophy along with Commissioner Jake Goddard. Receiving the trophy from His Excellency.
The 1972 Grey Cup game is over. The final score is Hamilton 13, Saskatchewan.